Many of us just can't get our day started without a cup of coffee. I know I love mine, but do we actually know what the caffeine in that coffee is doing to our bodies? And when too much is too much? Here's how to be mindful of your health when it comes to your caffeine fix. It's Jackie, and I am here with Katie, a dietitian, and today we are talking about all things caffeine. So caffeine, I think it would be great to start by just talking about what exactly it is, because it comes from both natural sources and man-made sources as well.
Absolutely. So caffeine, simply put, is a drug. It's a chemical. And it is naturally found in things like tea leaves and coffee beans. And then, of course, there is synthetic caffeine that is made in a lab.
Right. And we often think of caffeine being associated with coffee, but it goes beyond coffee to things like soda.
Soda, energy drinks, it's in some medications. Recently I saw it in peanut butter. So it's becoming very widespread.
Now, when it comes to caffeine, it has an effect on our body.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a stimulant. And so it increases your heart rate. It can increase your metabolism a little bit, but kind of makes things move a little faster.
We all probably should be aware of how much caffeine we're consuming, but there are some groups of people in particular who need to be especially cognizant of the caffeine they're consuming.
Absolutely. So first of all, if you notice that caffeine affects you, you're one of those people. Definitely, if you're pregnant or nursing, you want to limit your caffeine. It has effects on both you and the baby in that case. If you're taking other medications that are stimulants, so you want to ask your doctor or pharmacist to make sure that you're not compounding those stimulant effects.
So all of us, you know, can sometimes lose track of how much caffeine we're having since it's in so many different things. What is the recommended amount that we shouldn't exceed?
Yeah, absolutely. We talk about the recommended amount as 400 milligrams per day. Now, for most people, that means nothing to them because that's not how we talk. And so I brought a few examples. A coffee you're getting from a local coffee shop, that might be about 300 milligrams, actually.
So oh, wow.
You're actually getting pretty close with just that one cup of coffee. In a soda, anywhere from 60 to 100 maybe milligrams, and an energy drink kind of starts at 80 up to 150, depending if it's this big or, that big.
Now, if you're somebody who's pushing the limit of that 400 milligrams a day, what are some of the side effects you might notice? Why do we not want to exceed that?
Absolutely. You might find yourself having problems sleeping. You might be jittery. Just anxiety. You might not necessarily be shaking, but you find yourself just a little more irritated and angry and anxious during the day.
And not all caffeinated drinks are created equal. Some of these have more sugar in them.
If you're drinking coffee, it's really different if you're drinking it black than with a whole bunch of cream and sugar. Of course, when you get into the energy drinks and the soda, there's a lot of added sugar in those, which also might make you a little jittery on their own, and can really have, detrimental side effects as well as far as your health.
So the main takeaway here is just to be mindful of how caffeine affects you and also how much you're drinking.
You got it.
All right. Well, thank you. And we'd love to see how all of you caffeinate. Share your pictures with us on Instagram with our account Living Healthy TV.